Because on a smaller car, you know, trying to get past is not an easy thing. Because once you get to 140, you know, and you come down and you again have to get to 140, it's not easy. When I got my first bike, I actually started working, and then every day, because we were young kids, so going back and forth on the road, and it was a night job. So even in the night, you get empty roads, and even in the morning, you get empty roads. So every day going back and forth, we were just driving. I mean, all of the four or five people will leave together, same bikes, and they will just start racing, you know, on the same road. So every morning, this was a story. And then I started doing some upgrades on the bike, you know, trying to, you know, catch people. Another thing I would, of course, do is won't let them pass, because I have a smaller engine, they have a bigger engine. If you cannot win, don't make let them win as well. So, you know, just dirty play, you know, all that stuff. So the whole racing thing and all this thing, this comes from the area itself. So this racing thing, you know, it was there since always, you know, every day, because always worked there in the night. So every morning you get a lot of chance of, you know, doing all of this kind of stuff. And since it's bikes, so it's very limited. Nowadays, I think there's a lot of kind of heavy bikes, super bikes, and all that stuff. But it was not that a few years ago. Fast and Furious, of course, you know, started. I don't even know what cars they had, honestly. You know, for the first few ones, I did not really, you know, of course, I liked racing and all that stuff, but I did not really try to even look at what cars they were using. They were just driving, and that was the most fun part of me. As I even told you earlier, that driving on a straight road is just the car. It's basically the driver, you know, based on what you're driving through the road safely without making an accident, and of course being fast and making sure you're the first one ahead. Many stories where, you know, almost was about to hit a major accident but got saved. Don't really know how would I relate it now and explain it. But in between the cars, you know, if you're just lying on the bike and you're just trying to go around, funny stories, getting stopped by police, did not even have my license then, and then staying there for 1 hour and just speaking to them and getting the way out, you know, going without paying any money, of course, and getting into trouble. So those were always there. As I said, you know, coming back and forth from work was always racing on empty roads. In the night, it would just get more fun. And getting on the hill is just more fun as well. Coming down was more fun with no brakes sometimes. And the whole idea was don't brake and you have to just get off the hill. So those were crazy, crazy times as well. You know, three, four bikes just trying to pass each other, you know, all during the traffic hours. You know, that's the crazy part. Never got into a big trouble besides accidents, few accidents, of course. Here in UAE, I was tailgating one guy. So it was a Mustang, I think GT or something. And I was tailgating him. And all I wanted, because I was getting late for work, all I wanted was move and then I can go. I respect you. You have a bigger car, bigger engine, whatever. And he was not letting me, you know, go. So I just stayed at his back till, you know, he would move. And then he got angry and then he revved. He, I think, floored it and he just went away. And my friend was like, you know, that's a shame, you know. I said, why is it a shame? I mean, imagine he's doing this to a Toyota. Why don't he go and do this with some Dodge or Camaro or something he can stand up with? But it was just, you know, but because on a smaller car, you know, trying to get past is not an easy thing. Because once you get to 140, you know, and you come down and you again have to get to 140, it's not easy on a 1.3-liter engine. So getting to 140 and maintaining it was something which was, so you will always pass by, you know, trying to avoid police, trying to avoid accidents, you know. In a smaller car, you cannot really move freely or smoothly. So that's something that you need to, of course, you know, take care of while doing it. So with the Dodge, you know, of course, it was a fast car. Anytime I would, you know, really get along with some people, I know I can rev it and I can, you know, just go past it. But I never wanted to get any fines, so been a good driver. But anytime I get a chance, of course, we try to rev it and go fast. Right now, I've just put new tires, so I'm not gonna do it. But later on, yes, I want to do a few videos, have few video stuff in mind. But I don't think with these tires I can do that because I've just put 3 even 5s. They're really wide. and it just takes away the power from the V6. So I think I don't even remember I've hardly spun the car recently. Though if I do it in manual, it's very good. On the track day, what I was doing was, so I was doing it manually. So I was sliding the car full throttle all the time and doing it in manual. And since I had no brakes, so I had to do it manually. So you know, those things, you know, those were crazy. And I almost was making the car cry. You know, that's really one thing that you enjoy. And you cannot really do it on the roads with V6s or even V8s or anything above 2.2, 2.4, 2.5. It gets really hard to do it on the road unless you have a really clear way. So the first thing I did was white body. I got the white body and I got the spoiler. So a lot of people have commented on my spoiler and they've asked me where did I get it, how much I get it from. It's a red eye spoiler. So that one comes really nice. Usually you get an SRT or street flat spoilers. So this is a red eye one, so it kind of covers the whole back part and you know gives you a really nice, amazing look. So got the red eye spoiler and then of course the white body from Chrome and Carbon. They gave me a good deal altogether. Then after that I got wider rims. Of course that's a long story, long search I had to because I wanted to get something without the spacers because I did not really have a good experience with spacers before. I mean they don't really bear and drive, but once you remove them there is a lot of vibration in the car and it doesn't go away. Then I got 315s and 275s in the front, huge for a car like this. And when I drove it, it was a very smooth experience. I mean, on 100, 120, even the car just floats. Because on the 8th gear, the car becomes really cool and it just flows on the road. If you're just, you know, even changing lanes, it's very smooth. And then after that, I got so these rims were from Sharjah. I looked everywhere around and just a small shop in Sharjah, I found these rims. Someone had imported from US and all that stuff. Then I started thinking about getting a DRF. So I had many options, local, international market. There was Diode, there was Lightning Fence, there was 360 light. I got quotes from like everywhere, anywhere and everywhere. But then again, I wanted to do something which is more reliable. So most of the people told me to go with Lightning Fence. And of course, when I compared and all this stuff, I liked the options they were giving. So, you know, I contacted them directly. They even gave me a discount and everything because I did not end up buying it with them. But I did get and ended up getting it from MK1. He gave me a really good deal on the DRLs. Really nicely done. It was Corona period, so he came, he took the car, he went, finished it, came back, gave it to me. And then there was some, I think he something was missing. The signal was, they had a problem. They forgot to plug it. So the two Johnny took the car back again and he brought it back to me with it fixed. So very nicely done. So you know I was thinking, you know, rather than putting a lot of money in doing performance mods, I could just upgrade to RT or SRT to get more performance. But you know the more fun is, you know, the JDM things, you know, that do performance mods, make this thing compete with an RT or an SRT. That'll be more fun and more shame to other people, of course, on the road. But yeah, a long way to go because getting all those upgrades, it just gets difficult to get your car passed in the RTA. I never knew someone would call me and, you know, someone would want to hear my story because I'm just a simple guy. I don't have really exciting stories. Even if they were, I've even either forgotten them or either, you know, that's not something that I'm really proud of. But, you know, if you want to do a, let's say, a music video and all that stuff, a lot of people are doing it. But that requires a lot of mods and upgrades on the car. Get a wrap, get a funny wrap, and all that stuff, you know. So for me, it's just a simple car. I mean, for me, if you see on my car, it's all natural from the outside and inside. The only thing I've done, they're very similar to what Dodge produces now. There are fewer versions of the car, so I like those versions. Now I cannot get those versions, so what I've done is I've got the mods which actually relates to those and make it look like them. But other than that, I mean, it's a very simple car. Simple and it can be on the street with no problems, you know. So for me, you know, getting an opportunity like this to talk to someone about cars, people in UAE here, they're very less who knows about car. Even for me right now, I'm at a very beginning stage when it comes to the cars. You know, a lot of people contact me for the stuff that I've done. Yeah, for this stuff, ask me anything. You know, you can message me anything, and I'll tell you the different when I did it, even I did not know that there are so many other options available. But right now, so many people have got it, even from here, USA, Saudi. People ask me like, okay, what about these rims? You know, because you don't get these rims anywhere. Even in the market right now, it's not possible to get this offset. So I'm lucky I found it, and I have no idea how this guy got it from, or where he got it from. So anyway, a lot of people have asked me, because usually you get 2,500, the regular ones, Demon look alike, but they're not actual Demon, they're just China copies, and but they're not negative offset, they're the regular offset. So for the white bodies, getting a rim and putting no spacer is not something easy. So a lot of people even contact me for that, and that's something, you know, I never knew that, you know, I'll get so much of attention on Insta, and people, they would know me for what I've done to the car and who I am. So a lot of people started knowing me now. I've made a lot of more friends, such as yourself now, today, after the kind of conversation we had, the things we can relate to, of course, being to the cars and the personal life and the regular boy stuff. Younger generation, if you have goals, if you have dreams, always pursue them. If not today, if you're not getting something today, you will get it one day. I mean, I never knew I could even afford a Dodge, or I never knew I would do these kind of upgrades on the car, or I never knew that I would be on a YouTube channel, or I have a famous Instagram account, a little bit famous, yeah. Not that famous, but yeah, a little bit. I never knew I could sell real estate. If I look back, you know, a few years back, I would not know that I could have done all of this stuff. So the only thing is, stay focused. You would see a lot of motivational movies, videos. Simple as that. Stay focused. Yeah, you need to have a goal. Have a goal. Have a dream. Work for it. Stay focused and you'll get it.